the first cable, also the first riding, YK Center, and also Bob McLeod will also be involved in answering this first question. If you want to go in the order of Arlene first, followed by Robert, followed by Bob McLeod, that might be a little bit more straightforward. So I'll read the question. These should have been provided to you ahead of time, so hopefully you've had a little bit of time to reflect on it, and you have 1 minute to answer these questions. Again, the flag system will apply, with a warning at 15 seconds before the end. One and a half minutes, okay. And the warning will still be at 15 seconds before the end, okay. So question number one for Yellowknife Centre candidates and for Yellowknife South candidate, Bob McLeod. The GNWT's sustainable development policy calls for a balance between conservation initiatives and economic development. The last 4 years have seen the GNWT develop a greenhouse gas strategy, a water stewardship strategy, advanced the protected area strategy, etc. The Minister of Environment stated recently that the Northwest Territories Legislature is the most environmentally conscious legislature in the history of the Northwest Territories. In the face of this, mineral exploration is in the doldrums, a borrowing limit is being hit, and money is tight. So what about economic development? If you are elected, how would you correct this imbalance and put us on the path to becoming the most economically conscious legislature? Arlene Hache for Yellowknife Centre.
Just as it would be inaccurate to cast me as a one-issue candidate, it would not be accurate to cast the chamber members as people who don't care about the social fabric of the North. This question omits the third essential component for consideration in the pursuit of creating and supporting independent, whole, and healthy communities, and that is the social fabric of the community. Achieving balance between economic, environment, and social needs of the communities is critical, and all three carry equal weight. While imbalance may be a problem, the greater barrier to development is linked to the fact that the GNWT is awash in strategies that are developed through a navel-gazing approach rather than a broad-based collaborative system. The GNWT has been completely immobilized by government red tape and a mindset that is almost entirely focused on what they can't or won't do, not focused on what they could and will do. I want the 17th Assembly to be known for its capability in carrying out a visionary agenda that doesn't pit the economy, the environment, and social needs against each other. It's not in anyone's best interest to swing the pendulum radically from one side to the other. There are solutions. Reduce government red tape, initiate collaborative processes, set up negotiating teams that look to the territorial interests rather than their own interests, negotiate agreements that assure benefits stay in the North, implement devolution and revenue sharing agreements in partnership with Aboriginal governments, and assure communities and stakeholders have the resources and capacity to participate equally in discussions.
Thank you. Now for our second Yellowknife Centre candidate, Robert Hawkins.
Thank you, Jocelyn. I think the first solution here is to start tackling the AIP that was recently signed and sent back to Ottawa for ratification. We need that AIP to turn into a true devolution agreement. Right now, we do not have control over land and water resource boards, and we need control and stewardship over these things. The Northwest Territories needs to set the agenda for the future, not Ottawa. The other thing that I often hear about is the importance of a stable both tax regime and certainty in resource policy. When a mining company comes along and wants to provide a development and look at an opportunity, there is uncertainty for them. Can this project take 1 year? Can it take 2 years? Can it take 10 years to solve? It's nothing but a headache for resource industries that wants to look to the Northwest Territories. They're seeing that the Northwest Territories is closed for business. That our next government in the 17th Assembly has to look at a mining policy, an exploration policy, and I don't believe for one moment that economic opportunities can work against environment policies. I think they can work in collaboration, and I think that's really where our focus needs to be, is diversification and reaching out to these industries. As I said, a good focus on a mining policy and an exploration policy will help bring opportunities for all. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And our candidate for Yellowknife South, Bob McLeod.
Thank you very much. And I think in order to be able to answer this question properly, everybody has to understand what the difference is between a province and a territory. If you're a province, the province owns the land and the resources and the water. If you're a territory, the federal government owns the lands and the resources and the water. And the federal government is the one that makes all the decisions on resource development, economic development, and we need to change that. And I think that this last 16th Assembly, it was a policy that we undertook. We recognized that it was we weren't getting too far with Aboriginal governments in areas such as political development, devolution. So we felt that we could work together on the environmental agenda. And we were able to do that as witnessed by the fact that this question is quoting all of those achievements. So in order to turn this around, is my intention that we need to work even harder with the Government of Canada. The Government of Canada introduced CanNor, which has been moderately successful, but it's been funding on an ad hoc basis with no vision for economic development for the future. We need to work together to find a way to advance on devolution. We need devolution as part of the answer to increasing development. As well, I would work to develop a mining strategy. The Government of Northwest Territories needs to become an advocate for development, and we're prepared to do that. And of course, we need to diversify the economy with such a broad region and territory that not every region is the same.
That's it. You're done. Sorry. Thank you very much. All right. Thank you to our candidates for their answers.